Be our guest. Be our guest.
Quite out, and nothing was building in the villages underground.
I mean.
Please get that reference. Please, for the love of God, get that reference.
Something I have to get used to, but will also be very annoying. God.
Once again, for the second time, all the food in the world.
Stop eating honey.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 60 of Unknown Empire SMP. As you can see, there's been some changes to the server. Aside from this thunderstorm, we updated to 1.15 because season 2.5 has begun, and the admins decided to add some stuff. And with the update comes a lot of changes and developments to my own stuff. So I'm sure you've seen that I have discovered some bamboo over here, but you know, that's like the smallest thing there is. There is a handful of new characters that came with this, and some other new mobs, like this guy right here, Corporal Hypothermia. I found a stray. Well, actually, he kind of found me. He invaded my little farm outpost, whatever you want to call this place, the Dark Forest. So I gave him a job, and now he's gonna watch over it when I'm not here. Cause honestly, I'm not really here that much anymore, because of there's not really much of a reason to be. But aside from that, I found some. Or I discovered that you can create these brown mushrooms right here. And these are not my main supply of these guys. I'll show you those a little bit later. But yeah, I have a few here next to the red ones. And it's actually thunderstorming right now. But yeah, you can. I spent forever waiting for a thunderstorm, and one finally came, so I used my trusty Trident Thundershock to shock some of these red guys into brownies. So now I have an unlimited supply of suspicious stew, and I have no idea what kind of effect those are going to give me, so I guess we'll just have to see at some point. But that's really all there is out here in the Dark Forest. There's not really much else, but one thing that came with this update is that all of my villager companions have new skins, so I'm actually going to go to all of my locations with those villagers and show you guys their new costumes. Alright guys, we are here in Polartica, baby chicken for some reason, and I figured out that you can color sign text as well, so I went and made all of Polartica's blue, and I did a similar thing with the Skull Temple. But all of our villagers here and a couple of other developments, so let's go check some of those. So first we have Gordon here. If he would kindly get off of his chest. There we go. He's got like a headband looking thing. There we go, there he is. Gordon. Okay, he's kind of camera shy. I don't know what that's all about, but yeah, apparently Gordon does not want to show us what he looks like, but he's basically just the butcher skin. But Kevin's looking sharp in here. Well, I can actually get in here. Look at this guy. He's got a monocle now. He's all fancy. He's all fancy schmancy. And because I traded with him before to get some Woodland Mansion maps, he's actually Master Kevin. Trading Master Kevin. So, he's got this little diamond badge right there, so that's pretty cool. Kevin's still number one trading guy in here, and he's all fancy. And we also have a new thing over here, because I did a lot of off-island exploration, which I will show you guys a little bit later. But I made this, like, aquarium thing, and yeah, the pufferfish does not like me, but I got a ton of those. So, yeah, Polarctic Pool, beware of the pufferfish, as you can see. But yeah, look at all this. I made it like another aquarium type of thing with all sorts of tropical fish and obviously our little puffer friend right there who's taken to poisoning me. So, yeah, I will just leave him alone. Let's see, where is he? There he is. Alright, so I will leave him alone. But next up we have the outcast over this way. Also, check it out. Elytras have new skins for Optifine capes in 1.15, which is amazing. because now it really is the Skulk Glider. It's got a more spooky look to it. But we're gonna land right down here, and I wouldn't call him our friend, more like the troublemaker known as the Outcast, and he's asleep right now. Oh no, the Outsider. I always get his name wrong. Whatever. But yeah, he's a nitwit. He's still got the green sleeves. Our conduit engineer is going to look exactly like him, except he doesn't have a bed, so... Alright, sleepyhead. Let's just prank him. Shove him out of his bed. What's up, dude? So yeah, there's the Outsider. As well as Mr. Shrooms right over here. So we have a bunch more villager friends over this way. And first up, we have our newest room, the Suspicious Room. And this is my main supply of brown mushrooms. But of course, I have to have the spares in the Dark Forest because it took forever to finally get these guys. And now that I have them, there's thunderstorms like all the time. When it took me like a week waiting for one. But yeah, and we also have Suspicious Stewart back here. I actually found him in the Dark Forest. There were some zombie villagers and stuff invading my space, and I managed to rescue this guy. I had to track him through the mountains after the thunderstorm was over. But yeah, now I'm keeping an eye on our friends here. I also have some decorative bamboo. And there's really no way around the way this place looks, but you know, it's a weird room and it's not really meant for people besides me, so yeah, these are my brown mushrooms, and I'm gonna be farming some stew off of those guys. But let's see, ice hounds are in there. Next up we have George, the little baby villager that I raised from the Dark Forest, and like Kevin, he's a master of the trade, so you can get all the things from him. And then across the way here we have our blacksmith, the jacksmith, and this guy looks way cooler now. I mean, look at him, he's got an eye patch. Part of his dark history there. But yeah, let's see, what is he? He's a novice. I think that's the lowest rank. So yeah, I might have to do some more trades with these guys. I think he's a weaponsmith, I think, so eventually he can trade bells, which are uncraftable. So that might be useful, and I'll show you why in a bit. But yeah, I think that's it for Polartica, pretty much. I think we've went through all of our villager friends and such, so next we are going to go to Voldera and take a look at Victor. Alright, so these next couple guys are going to be pretty quick, but Victor over here, our Skulk Quest guy, he's got glasses now. I guess he had some sight problems, and this hat that's kind of weird looking, not gonna lie. Sorry, Victor. But yeah, that's his new look. And of course, right down here in good old Traveler's Landing, we have the ever famous Jeff the Chef, who is a lot more camera friendly than Gordon, I must say. So he's kind of got the same outfit but a green face. And now we're in the Skulk Temple. And Skulton doesn't really like to stay in one place anymore, and he kind of has flailing arms, but he's not our main focus. So we have a few villager characters in here, as well as some new signs. Hopefully people can see those okay. But our first villager is Ol Unreliable, the least trustworthy friend I have. So he's got this purple robe on like George, because he's some sort of a cleric guy. And down here, we actually have a new friend, this black cat Lux right here. He's fancy. I call him Lux the Tux because he's a tuxedo cat. But yeah, he's chilling up here with the Skulk Hounds. And down here, Eerie actually looks a little bit different. So let's see, where is she? There she is. Right next to our good buddy Tombstone. Let's see, Eerie. Eerie is a completely black cat, extra spooky, with the orange eyes. So yeah, she's looking pretty good too. Yep, ready to cause some mischief, haunt some people. It's gonna be a great time. And now down in the prison, I think, is where our next companions are. Oh, I got the magma cubes here. Spooky Bart, here, Creeper. And yeah, the pumpkin guys look a bit different too. I'm not so sure about General Pumpig's new pumpkin. But yeah, we gotta clear out this place. So unfortunately, we don't have the Dimwit anymore. I have no clue what happened to him. My guess is that either Zombert, who's got a nice farmer hat now, and Catherine. Oh, she just smacked me. How rude. I thought we were starting to be friends. I was just about to let you out. No, I wasn't. But my best guess is that it's Deadeye over here, who seems to have two Deadeyes now. They're both red. And he's got, like, some sort of welding mask, I think. I don't know what profession this is. I think he's, like, an armorer, maybe? But he's in the neighboring cell to, Mr. Keeper here. So, you know, the vicious Deadeye, I'm sure, is the one who ate the Dimwit. But you know what? I don't really miss him. But also, just quickly check out this. There's campfires now. So I can actually make these look a little bit better so that our escaped prisoner over here has some quality decorations in her little camp here. Over here we also have a new campfire in our old endgame base, which I don't think is ever going to be touched again. But we also have Oscar, if you remember this guy. I don't really know what he is, but he's got a new look to him. He's like the outsider, but with a green face. So, how's it going, Doug? He's kind of bored. Maybe I'll have to find a new job for him or something. And then in the not-so-forbidden kingdom itself, we have Edward. I introduced you guys to this dude last time, and he's our receptionist, I guess. Secretary, whatever you want to call him, but he kind of works the desk of the Forbidden Kingdom, make sure nobody suspicious enters, and he's got the same bad eyesight as Victor, I guess. And over here we have the Forbidden Farmhouse once again, where Farmer Dave works, and he's got that nice farmer hat like Zombert, and I actually have a few of these farmer guys. His job at Polumbra has actually been replaced, and that's my next location that we're going to go to. So I'd have to say that Polumbra is probably going to be the most significant place in this entire video, because I've been doing the most work here. So, as you can see, there's a few more villagers here now, as well as this bell. So, yeah, this place has turned into a legitimate village. It spawned its own enforcer, and it's also been spawning cats around. And so we have Caretaker John. He was the dude who was here before, and he's, I think, a shepherd, so he sells wool and stuff like that, and this is where he lives. We have Fred here. He's kind of like Deadeye. He's got the armor skin. Let's see who else. Everybody is asleep. We got Johan, who is actually a zombie villager, and this is how the repopulation began with this guy. And then we have a stray cat right here. Let's send this guy out. I'm not really going to tame him because I have a bunch of other ones. And there's our rabbit. And, oh yeah, this little troublemaker here goes in many places he's not supposed to. And, you know, we don't really need to go into details of how these new villagers came to be. But, oh no, the cat just killed the rabbit. Oh, that's disappointing. If you weren't orange, I'd get rid of you. But I have a soft spot for orange cats. So, and then this is Yukon, Johan's twin brother. He's like the fisherman. Let's see, everybody is asleep right now. That's kind of unfortunate. Oh, yes, here. Farmer Daniel, he does not know how to sleep in his bed, apparently. So, yeah, he sleeps in here. They don't really match up with their profession blocks, unfortunately. But watch this. I can wake people up with the bell. This guy's already awake, but yeah, now everybody's awake now. And one guy, this kind of, I have no idea who this is. He's taken up residence in Lieutenant Lefty's room here, and he doesn't really like that. But he's fighting the restraint to kill this guy because he knows the enforcer would get into an argument, even though he's technically supposed to be under his command. Get out of there. That's Lefty's bed. But anyway, I also have Snowball. This was the first cat that spawned in this village. With the two different colored eyes, so she's an interesting one. So she's hanging with Maximus, Lefty, and yet to be named. But yeah, that's pretty much everybody in Polumbra here. Oh, Mr. Wingman has achieved an elytra from Tekkit, it seems. So yeah, that's all of our new friends. I'm really happy about how Polumbra has turned out. It's a legitimate village that I kind of made it into, because it went from just one guy, John, over there to some more peoples. And oh wow, you're grown up now, aren't you? What should I call you? I wonder what I should call these next two guys. He's gonna be like the jobless deadbeat of the town. So I gotta come up with some really goofy name for him. But yeah, this is the debut for a lot of these yahoos. So yeah, this is this guy. I like his snow hat though. It's pretty cool. But yeah, he lives in the corner of town. He's kind of exiled. No one really likes him, and for good reason. But yeah, that's it for Polumbra. I'm really excited about this place. And also, village raids can happen here, so I better not come here with bad omen. But speaking of that, it's time to show you guys my off-island exploration and all of the loot that I got from it. So I'm going to play those clips right now, because I found a lot of stuff and went to a lot of places deep into the wilderness, which is how I found stuff like this bell right here, which I love waking the villagers up. Sorry, guys, but yeah. So I'm going to show you guys the exploration, all the things that I did and found during my journey. Thank you. Slay him. And there we have it. Let's get out of here. See a village down there. Let's go start ourselves a raid. Coming. This way, I'm gonna get some tokens of undying and monsters hunted advancement. That's Vindicator. Breaking the village down. Oh, sweet. Okay, I didn't get a evoker guy though. So maybe I'll have to try it again. Here we go. Time for round two. Alright. Raid number two.
Huh.
Hey, thanks for the emeralds, dude. Oh, wow, look at this guy. Hey. Alright, let's go get these guys. Oh, there's a Ravager in here. Oh, here he is. Let's use the big guy for this. Die! Let's leave you out of this fight. Oh, and that's it again. Okay. Again, no evokers for some reason. Alright, you guys, so as you can see, I had quite the adventure off the island, and apparently the Kingdom of the Skull is also breeding new villagers. But yeah, I got a ton of loot, you guys would not believe, so let's see. This is one, this is one, this is one, and all of these shulker boxes, and I think that they might all be full. So let's just open these guys up and view the immense amount of stuff that I acquired on my trip. So first up in the cyan shulker box, we have some flowers, fishing rods, all these leather armor from like shipwrecks and stuff, some stew. This is like the sea goodies and such. So we got like buried treasure maps and stuff like that. Conduits, diamonds, iron, gold, emeralds. And in this one, we have, ooh, these are my new crossbows that are pretty cool. So let's try them out on some unsuspecting keepers here. So let's warm these guys up with the depressor. And then let's see, sharp shot. Let's use this one. There we go. That one's a piercing one. So it has, let's see, piercing 4, unbreaking 3, quick charge 2, and mending. And then let's try tri-shot on this guy. This will be multi-shot, so we'll shoot 3 arrows at once, as you can see, right there. And let's see, what does this one have on it? Unbreaking 3, multi-shot, quick charge 3, and mending. So it charges up a bit faster than the other one. So let's see. Yeah, look at all those arrows. Crazy. So yeah, that's quick shot, or sharp shot and try shot. And in addition to that, we have horse armor, a bunch of bee nests that I have yet to really do anything with. Another buried treasure map. All the leather. Protection 4, bamboo. Guarantee you this is a thunderstorm, because that's just how the world works. This one, we got all the honey things, because I've actually been farming bees, and I, as you saw at the way beginning of the episode, so I'll make sure to show you guys that in a minute. But, yeah, we got honey blocks, honeycombs, a bunch of other stuff. I'm gonna make this into a channeling, or, no, riptide trident. That's the one I don't have, because I have a lot of the lightning ones. And yeah, a couple of these other things here that I acquired from the sea, the ocean monument, and some other places. And then this one, this is, oh yeah, the ocean thing with all the pufferfish and the coral and stuff like that. This, I think, is my suspicious stews, yeah. I think these are like night vision regen, fire resistance, and who knows what those two are. And then this is the raid loot with berries from the taiga, some saddles, a ton of crossbows. This one's got a firework loaded into it. The ominous banners. Oh man. I don't know what I'm gonna do with these, but I'm gonna do something. So yeah. Let's see which one is this one. And some axes from Vindicators, some other stuff. 6 bells. So, yeah, I might be the only one with bells. I'm probably going to implement a bell into this place and Venomora, because then they'd be like really real villages at that point, because all we're really missing is bells. And I know Tatras has had some bells put into it, but I'm not really going to go there. The nitwits. So yeah, that's it for like the loot and stuff that I acquired. So I'm gonna put all of that away, and then I will show you guys the bees, and that'll be that. So yeah, I will see you guys in the Lost Kingdom farmhouse. Alright, here we are. It's just down here, and you guys saw this at the very beginning of the video, but this is where my bee farms are. So, oh, we actually have some honey something ready for harvest, so I'll just show you guys how this works. So, you have to have a campfire underneath it so that the bees don't get mad at you, but you just shear it or you use a bottle on it, depending on if you want the honeycombs or the bottled honey. But yeah, this is a just a nest, right? Or that's a hive. That's a man-made one, because sometimes the bees will glitch through the walls or something and get out. So yeah, this is the farm I finished in episode 52, and I didn't show this, but there's actually this whole underground farm sequence down here, and I should really put like a composter down here so those guys can get back to work. But yeah, there's nothing really special down here, just your basic farming goods that Forge put together long before I was ever here. So yeah, and I have a couple bee farms on the higher levels. So we got bee farm number 2, there's another full hive right here, or a nest. I never know which one is which. All the bees seem to be in their hives right now, but yeah, we got 3 and 4, so let's see. Ah, here we go, here's the bees. And there's more in this room than than there really should be. And actually, one of these, which shulker box was it again? Was it the gray one? It was. So some of these have some bees in them. I don't know. Some of them might not. But yeah, I'm gonna figure out what to do with those at some point, because I don't really know how I'm gonna implement them into this farm, or I might even put them somewhere else and have a couple bee farms going. But yeah, so we're just gonna shear this, get the honeycombs, because I don't have any bottles with me, and we'll let our bees get back to work. And this is the 4th farm. There's a couple in here. These guys are also full. I'm not really sure what I'm going to be using this honey stuff with, but there we go. It'll be for something. So, and also I've been breeding a couple bees as well. So yeah, let's see if I can actually get some. Do I have any flowers or any of that stuff? Yes, I do. So let's see if these guys will breed for us. There we go. We'll get a baby bee in here. There we go. Look at that little guy. But yeah, that is pretty much all I have to show you guys. So yeah, we just got our bee farm. They're hard at work, and I have 4 more nests with I don't know how many bees in them. Probably not that many. I think the most I have in one of them is like 2. So yeah, but that's it for this episode, guys. I hope that you all enjoyed, and I guess I'll see you guys next time, where we're gonna start some story events. There's a new story going on, and then after that, I think we're gonna get to the Skolt quest, which I know I said would be this episode, sorry, but it just had to be pushed back a little bit because of all this other stuff. So yeah, I hope that you guys enjoyed this episode, and I will see you guys in the next one. Goodbye!